Welcome you all to my YouTube channel. This is Akansha. In this video, I'm going to explain you one of the name reaction from the organic chemistry, that's a Prinz reaction. So let us start learning about Prinz reaction. Always enjoy the chemistry and enjoy the learning and also enjoy this reaction. The Prinz reaction is an organic name reaction which is categorized in the coupling reaction, or we can say it has the kind of the coupling reaction. The reaction is named after a Dutch chemist, Hendrik Jacob Prinz. Now, what is the historical background behind this reaction? How this Hendrik Prinz gave this reaction which we call as an Prinz reaction? The Hendrik Prinz gave this reaction during his doctoral research. Actually, during his doctoral research in the year 1911 and 1912, he gave the two reaction of to the addition of the olefin. The first one was the addition of the polyhalogen to the olefin, and the second one was the addition of the aldehyde to the olefin, which he called as an Prinz reaction. But the use of this reaction was quite suppressed until 1937. But later on, this reaction came up with its importance, and the Prinz reaction emerged as a powerful reaction for a formation of the CO and the CC bond. We can say that a Prinz reaction is mainly meant for a formation of the CO and the CC bond by using the olefin and the aldehyde. You can see here the general scheme of this reaction, of the Prinz reaction, which is an electrophilic addition of the ketone or aldehyde to the alkene, or we can use as an alkyne, which is followed by the attack of nucleophile. By the attack of the nucleophile, we get this product, that is an alcohol, or by the elimination of the H plus ion, we get the allylic alcohol as an product, or by the excess of the formaldehyde over here, we get the 1,3-dioxane. Actually, generally by seeing the product, we can say it has the outcome of the reaction depend upon the reaction condition. That is, we can get a product as the allylic alcohol, simple alcohol, or a 1,3-dioxane. So you must be wondering how the product are different by the same reactant, correct? There might be some different reaction conditions, so that we are getting a different product over here. So let us see how it is. Now we will move towards the mechanism of this reaction, which makes us more clear that how the different product are get forming by using the same reactant over here. So let us see the mechanism of this reaction. Now learning the mechanism of the Prinz reaction. That is, let us learn how the mechanism of the Prinz reaction results in the formation of the different products. The first step in the mechanism of the Prinz reaction is the formation of the intermediate, that is a beta hydroxycarbocation. Now, how this intermediate is get formed? We know in a Prinz reaction, the substrate are the aldehyde and the alkene. Here, the formaldehyde is a substrate. Firstly, in a first step, that is a formation of the intermediate, that is a beta hydroxycarbocation, this aldehyde get protonated, that result in the formation of the oxonium ion. We know that the oxonium ion is a species in which oxygen carries a positive charge attached with the three bonds. So the oxonium ion, it undergo resonating structure. Here the carbon carry the positive charge, act as an electrophile over this alkene, and we get the form carbocation, which we call as an beta hydroxycarbocation, or simply we can call it as an carbocation. Actually, in the Prinz reaction, these carbocation is responsible for forming the different product over here. That is, it can form the allylic alcohol, it can form the dioxane, or it can form the diol. Now, firstly, how this allylic alcohol is get formed? Here the first step is similar over here. The aldehyde get protonated, only the concentrate only on the black portion. Okay. Here, firstly, this aldehyde get protonated by the proteic acid, oxonium ion, resonating structure, attack on this alkene, that formation of the intermediate. Here, the water will abstract this proton. This bond will restore over here, double bond will create it, and we get the allylic alcohol, and H3O plus will be the side product. This is how the allylic alcohol is get formed. Now, the second step, that is the formation of the diol. How these diols are formed? There is attack of nucleophile on the intermediate. How here the nucleophile will act on this directly on this carbocation, we get a product, that is a diol, or simple alcohols are also formed. Here, as a water act as a nucleophile, so we get here the diol as the product. In a second case, how this dioxane are formed, that is how the 1,3 dioxane are formed. In the presence of the excess of formaldehyde over here, this formaldehyde itself acts as a nucleophile. The attack of nucleophile over this carbocation will take place. Only concentrate the green portion over here, okay? This formaldehyde will act as a nucleophile. On these carbocation, the ring closure reaction will take place, and after this, the elimination of this proton, H3O plus will be the side product, and we get a product, the dioxane. This is how the mechanism of the Prince reaction is responsible for the formation of the different product. The first step is the formation of the beta hydroxy carbocation, which is mainly responsible for the forming the dioxane, allylic alcohol, and the diol. The allylic alcohol is formed by the elimination. Sometimes the formation of the allylic alcohol is get confused with the Ehn reaction, but don't get confused with it. They both are quite different. And then this is a diol by directly attack of the nucleophile, and in the presence of the excess of formaldehyde, what we get here, diol. Now let us revise the same mechanism. This is again aldehyde which get protonated by the protic acid. Attack of this on the alkene, we get a beta hydroxy carbocation. This vary with a different reaction. Firstly, by the formation of the allylic alcohol here, this proton will get abstracted by this water molecule. Here double bond will create it. We get allylic alcohol as a product. Formation of the 1,3 dioxane, the excess of formaldehyde itself act as a nucleophile. The ring closure will take place, and we get an 1,3 dioxane as a product. And direct attack of nucleophile over the carbocation, we get a alcohol as a product. This is how the Prince reaction mechanism, and this was all about the Prince reaction mechanism, how we get a different product. And this is again example of the Prince reaction only. Just here the alkene is highly substituted. This is that result in the formation of the allylic alcohol, simple alcohol, by the nucleophilic attack. And excess of aldehyde attack, it will result in the formation of the 1,3 dioxane. Now if we see how this product vary, how when the allylic alcohol is formed, when the alcohol is formed, and when the 1,3 dioxane is formed, here some conditions are given, so let us read it one by one. With a water and a protic acid such as sulfuric acid as a reaction medium and the formaldehyde, the reaction product is 1,3 diol. And when the water is absent, the cationic intermediate loses a proton to give the allylic alcohol. That means we can say simply, when the nucleophile is absent, then that cationic intermediate loses a proton to give the allylic alcohol. When excess of formaldehyde is there and the no reaction temperatures are there, generally we get a dioxane. When the temperature is low and excess of formaldehyde is present, and we get a 1,3 dioxane as a product. And excess of aldehyde and a temperature, when a temperature is less than 70 degrees, that results in the formation of the acetyl. And when one equivalent of the aldehyde is used and a temperature are greater than 70 degrees, means at a higher temperature we get a allylic alcohol over here, and at a lower temperature we get a 1,3 dioxane. This is clear from the reaction condition that how different products are get formed, and we also seen the mechanism of the Prince reaction. So thank you all for watching this video. I hope you like the content which I share with you. So please like, share, and subscribe my channel for a further update. Always learn chemistry, live with the chemistry, definitely you will enjoy it. And thank you.